From the first stirrings of life beneath water, to the great beasts of the Stone Age, to man taking his first upright steps, you have come far. Now begins your greatest quest, from this early cradle of civilization on towards the stars.
Nzinga Mbande, Queen of Dongo and Matamba, Warlord of the Imbangala, you know too well that power is not granted, but must be made anew in each instant. Beware those who would seize your lands and your people for their own ends. Strike back against those who would conspire against you and take what is yours, if not by right, then by grand vision.
Civilization has accomplished something historic, worthy of being celebrated and remembered for generations to come. These accomplishments help our civilization reach a golden age and avoid a dark age.
Who deserves more credit than the wife of a coal miner?
Thank you.
Our governor is now on their way to their assigned city. It will take some time for them to become established there. Once established, their talents will come into effect, strengthening our rule there. Enacting new policies in our government can be of great benefit. Our people await your decree.
At his best, man is the noblest of all animals. Separated from law and justice, he is the worst.
City-state neighbors have made a request of us. If we can impress them, I think they will reward us handsomely.
If there are no dogs in heaven, then when I die, I want to go where they went.
have recently gained advanced knowledge in city planning. Creating districts in our cities can be much more powerful and lucrative than simple improvements like farms and mines.
A physician without a knowledge of astrology has no right to call himself a physician. Bravery is being the only one who knows you're afraid. No man ever wetted clay and then left it, as if there would be bricks by chance and fortune.
My liege, we have an envoy at our disposal. We can use the envoy to gain favor with the city-state. Becoming friendly with a city-state neighbor can be greatly beneficial to our civilization.
Mysticism is the mistake of an accidental and individual symbol for a universal one. Bronze is the mirror of the form, wine of the mind.
As our civic knowledge grows, so do our methods of governance. Furthering this endeavor will allow us to appoint a governor to strengthen our power in our cities.
Skill without imagination is craftsmanship and gives us many useful objects, such as wickerwork picnic baskets. May the forces of evil become confused while your arrow is on its way to the target.
Once again, we have the opportunity to enhance our powers of governance. We can use it to promote one of our existing governors, or we can appoint another new governor to our civilization.
Thank you.
look back over the past with its changing empires that rose and fell, and you can foresee the future too. Can you imagine trying to talk 600 people into helping you drag a 50-ton stone 18 miles across the countryside and muscle it into an upright position and then saying, right lads, another 20 like that, then we can party.
Our populace has attracted a great profit to our lands. Send this most holy person to Stonehenge and rejoice, for the time has come to found a religion for ourselves. Civilizations have uncovered new technologies and civics, and soon the world itself will reach the dawn of a new era. Our actions in this era may lead us into a golden age for our civilization, or perhaps darker days lie ahead.
Every nation lives by exchanging.
We are now ready to choose where to build our government buildings. We may only zone one of these in our empire, so choose carefully.
The man who has grit enough to bring about the afforestation or the irrigation of a country is not less worthy of honor than its conqueror. A strong economy begins with a strong, well-educated workforce.
My liege, we are beginning to attract the attention of the great people of the world. Of course, there are other leaders vying for their attention too. The more specialized districts we construct, the more we will draw in specialized great people to share their talents with our civilization. I advise that we continue to build these. Time has come to choose which of our accomplishments to commemorate in our history. This will inspire our people to continue to press forward towards a path of your choosing. History marches forward, and the world has entered a new era. We may see a golden age or a dark age in our civilization's future, born from the actions of our recent past.
Sometimes the wheel turns slowly, but it turns.
addition to bringing riches to our civilization, this trade route will gradually develop roads between our cities. Roads allow our units to no longer be impaired by the difficult terrain through which they pass.
History is the version of past events that people have decided to agree upon. Money, if it does not bring you happiness, will at least help you be miserable in comfort. Writing is easy. All you have to do is cross out the wrong words. People who cannot find time for recreation
are sooner or later to find time for illness. We can no more have exact religious thinking without theology than exact mensuration and astronomy without mathematics, or exact iron making without chemistry. A man on a horse is spiritually as well as physically bigger than a man on foot.
the opportunity has arrived for a change into a new and more powerful system of government. Let us strengthen our identity and enact more policies to govern our people.
Divide and rule, a sound motto. Unite and lead, a better one.
Your Grace, we have obtained greater knowledge in the art of building static fortifications. Building walls around our cities will not only make them stronger against a foreign invader, but will also allow them to bombard nearby enemies.
Each of us is carving a stone, erecting a column, or cutting a piece of stained glass in the construction of something much bigger than ourselves.